It ain't nothing to cut that bitch off.
Turn up.
That's your shit, Mac?
Turn up.
See, because you think about a bitch you cut off, you cut her water off, huh?
Cut it all off.
See, that's what I thought about the bitch when I cut her water off. When the bitch was in mid, get ready to take a shower mode. And I cut the off. Bitch off.
That perfect.
Right off.
Yeah. She couldn't even go out that night. She had to stay home with the kids.
Couldn't go out that night.
Because I cut that bitch off.
Cut off.
Welcome to L.A.,
yeah,
my little
boy.
Cousin.
Welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we'd like to welcome you inside the GGN News Network. I'm your host with the most, Finding Nemo, a.k.a. Nemo Hoes. And today I got a very, very, very special guest on my show, all the way from the motherfucking A.
Turn up.
It's the one and only
K-Camp.
Camp, what it do, loved one?
What it do, huh?
How you doing, nephew?
Man, cooling.
Come on, man.
Myself, you dig?
Man, come on, man. It's a pleasure to have you on the show.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And knowing your struggle and knowing where you're going with it and how you continuously making hot music and doing what you're doing. How does it feel to be accepted and appreciated?
It feel real good, you know what I'm saying? Because I started from the bottom, like you said, you know what I'm saying? Put in that street work, been in the streets forever, man, just to have the world finally, you know what I'm saying, tune in to what I got going on, man. It's a blessing. We're going to keep working.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed.
And when you started doing what you was doing, what was your goal? Was it just to be known in Atlanta, or was it like, you know what, I want to be a real respected, you know, bona fide musician?
I ain't gonna flex. When I first started, I just wanted everybody my school to hear my shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I was just playing it on my bus, and I woke up in the morning like, man, listen to this shit. But nah, after a while, when I figured out I was actually good at the shit, you know what I'm saying, I was like, okay, let's take this to another level. You know what I'm saying? Let's let the clubs hear. Let's let the whole city hear. We just kept going with
when
it.
When you was doing it in school, was it forced on you? Was it like somebody saying, like, nigga, can't,
nah.
Nigga, you dope, nigga, you need to do this shit? Or was it just like you just knew?
Yeah, I knew. It was never forced, you know what I'm saying? They told me I was dope as hell, you know what I'm saying? But I hear this shit all the time, so I was just like, all right, cool. But after a while, I just knew that this is what I needed to do.
So you a 90s baby?
90, man, 1990.
Damn.
Yeah, man.
Damn, 90s baby.
What you were doing in the 90s, though?
Man, I was doing everything, moving, man. I was wild, young, crazy, you know, on the edge.
Yeah.
So that's why I say it's dope to see that players like yourself, how y'all reinventing the game. Like, you're making the game sound fresh and different.
Yeah.
And you doing you. You know what I'm saying? It's easy to do you. It's hard to try to be somebody else, but it's so easy doing you, ain't it?
Too easy.
So who were some of your influences, you know, making music before you started making music?
Before I started, shit, man sitting next to me right now, you know what I'm saying, the OG. Outkast, UGK, Bone Thugs, Biggie Pop. You know, stuff like that, man. T.I., Gucci, Jeezy, all that.
So the success of that cut her off.
It ain't nothing to cut that bitch off. It ain't nothing to cut that bitch off.
Turn up, turn up, turn up.
Look, so yeah. What you saying, ho? You know I'm the man, ho.
That was real big. So how did that feel to finally have a record that you knew that the whole world, because I go to Europe, I go to Asia, I go to Australia, everywhere I go,
they playing it.
Nigga, I DJ, I play it.
You play it?
Yeah, and when that's I play shit. It and they know it, that mean, nigga, you gotta hear record.
Gotta hear record, right.
It's like, I'm not teaching it to them, when they come on,
they bumping already.
It ain't nothing to cut that bitch off.
For real,
they
true.
Do the dirty version.
Real life too, though. But nah, I mean, that's how I feel. It was crazy, you know what I'm saying? Because I put out that Money Baby first, you know what I'm saying?
Money Baby.
I was the first one to like to bust down the door, and then when I came with that cut off right after, it just right past Money Baby, and just, because I didn't want that to be my single. I just put it out on some mixtape shit just to get the streets bubbling. And the streets ate it up, the strip clubs ate it up, and that thing went number one, man.
See, but that's, like you said, I didn't put it out for that, but you can't control
it. You can't control it. That's the thing about this music. You can't control it.
Yeah, because
folks like.
And it'd be the ones where you'd be like, okay, I'm going to put this out because I want this to be the single, and they don't even
fucking with it. Man, I've been through that so many times.
Right?
So many times.
It's like, we make bad decisions. Let them make the decision.
Yeah, let the streets make the decision.
Because they ain't going to never lead you wrong. If it's banging, it's going to bang in the club first and foremost.
Exactly.
And that's your first feedback, especially being from Atlanta. You can go to the club at 4 a.m, 5 a.m, 1 p.m. You can go check it out. And if the women, if they requesting that record.
You on.
Boy, they coming out to that record, you in there.
Yep. If the stripper's requesting it, you on.
See, but that's a game that y'all got in Atlanta that some places around the world ain't fortunate to have. That's why y'all music controlling the club right now.
Yeah.
Because it was born in the club.
Right. Exactly.
So does it make you want to make other styles of music, or does it make you want to just stick to this Atlanta shit that you know?
Nah. I make the club shit just when I'm just in the club mood, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I bring so much more to the table. If you go listen to In Due Time, you see the range, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about everything, but coming from Atlanta, that's what they want to hear. So if you want to really break in Atlanta, you got to hit them in the club first, you know what I'm saying? You got to bring that club shit and make these motherfuckers move before you even get a chance to do what you want to do, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, Atlanta women, man, I mean, how did you grow up out there, man? Like, hey, with man. All those beautiful women around you.
Cappy G.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
So it taught you how to be a player.
Exactly.
At an early age, right?
Mm-hmm. That's Granddad dope. Was a player.
For real?
Real life.
That's dope.
Mm-hmm.
So it's in your genes?
It's in my genes, okay. Man.
Tell us about the mixtape One Way.
Oh, man, One Way, man. That's gonna be the biggest thing of 2015, if you ask me.
When is it coming out?
It dropped on the 19th, MLK Day.
Oh, that's dope.
It's probably like 13 tracks on there, all solid. Probably like 7, 8, 9 radio singles on there.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? That's how we did with In Due Time. We had too many hits on that project. We had to let song go. You feel me? But I'm real excited about dropping this One Way project, though.
So who are some of the features on there?
Some of the features on One Way. I give out one. I got Breezy on there.
For real?
I got Breezy on there. I get that out, cut out the bag.
Mm.
I got Ty Dolla on there.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? West Coast, we got to bring it to the West.
Yes, sir.
What else I got on there as of right now? Boosie.
Lil Boosie?
I got Boosie on there.
Who are some of the producers on there?
Some of the producers, I got Fruit, my in-house producer. He made that money, baby. He made me with Snooty. I got Sonny Digital on there. What else I got on there? One of my other in-house producers, Bobby Critical, Nash B.
That's
you know what I'm saying? I like to keep it in, you know what I'm saying? Keep it with my squad and grow with them, you feel me?
So niggas.
Exactly. So that's what we got going with that.
How did it feel for you to get 2 nominations for the BET Awards?
How did it feel? It felt good. It would've been better if I won them shits, though.
But you know, the nomination side, this is what you gotta learn to appreciate. When they start nominating you, you on the radar now.
Yeah.
So now it's your job to make records bigger than the last record that you just made.
Right, right.
That's all they wanna see is that you can
I still do it?
Outdo what you've done. Cause it's always, oh, he's a one-hitter quitter.
Yeah.
Or the sophomore jinx. Mm-hmm. Or he can't do it again.
Yeah.
Or he didn't fell off. That come with the territory. That's why you gotta have that bounce back.
Mm-hmm.
That be able to, you know, okay.
Hit him again,
if that was the biggest record that you had this year, well damn, next year he had 4 of those.
Right. We gonna come with it too.
As you should.
We gonna come with it.
I know you is, nigga. I know what
and
you
we do. Got something special for him for the album. That verse,
Lord, have mercy, Jesus.
We ain't gonna tell him.
Please don't.
Tell him.
I tell you, I stay connected, man. That's what I'm gonna say.
We got something special for him.
I stay connected, man.
Let's get it.
So how you like living in L.A.?
I love L.A., man. I love the weed. I love the women.
We love you.
I love the vibe.
We love you.
You know what I'm saying? I get a good vibe out here recording and all that, so I love it. I ain't got no complaints about L.A.
I'm just gonna raise the roof and do the robot. Wrist, elbow, shoulder. Look, laugh. Go ahead, laugh at home because I'm making a fucking fool of myself. I can't be good at everything. The fuck? I had to have a flaw somewhere. I'm good at a lot of things, actually. I could draw really well, and I'm good at being a good ass person. You are not make a fool of me on GGN, okay?
Ancient Volume 2 Wally West Ancient.
Am I really a scary person?
Mm-hmm.
That's why I don't have a boyfriend.
So what you working on right now?
Shit, we finishing up the One Way. You know what I'm saying? It ain't never done until it's dropped. You feel me? Like, ain't nothing ever done until it dropped.
So you just in the studio and just making hits. Like, because I know how my process is. If I got a record and then all of a sudden I make a song that's doper than something on this motherfucker, well, something got to get moved out the way.
Exactly. Scratch that motherfucker and bring a new one in. Exactly how I work.
Yeah, ain't no,
you know what I'm saying?
This shit ain't set in stone, you know what I'm saying? Like, I could fuck around and make a song tonight that'll blow this shit out the water where it's like, you know what?
Exactly.
I be doing that shit
all the time. I pull, just bring shit in. Mm-hmm. But I'm working on that one way in an album, my debut album.
And what's the process like? How long does it usually take for you to do a record? Do you have like a time period? Like, okay.
I like to record fast. I can't be in the booth for too long. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Then I start getting goddamn blocked. But I say that the fast is probably like 15 minutes. If I'm really feeling some shit, 15 minutes, I can knock that thing out.
Well, I got a 20-minute rule that, you know, niggas, some niggas hate it, some niggas love it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when I used to have niggas at my spot, they used to get down. I give a nigga 20 minutes, nigga. If it take more than 20 minutes, nigga, you ain't meant for this motherfucker.
Word, I'm telling you. I hate sitting for watching a rapper to
the beat got to just play 100 times, nigga. Nigga, I done came up with something by now,
for
nigga.
For real, I'm telling you. I got no patience for that shit.
Yeah, for real. 20-minute rule. He said 15 minutes. Damn. Yeah. These young MCs are
cut off 15 minutes.
For real?
I freestyled that whole record like 15 and put that motherfucker out.
And it feels so fresh.
It feels fresh.
especially when I see a nigga come in the club, right? And then, you know, this time he ain't with his girlfriend that he used to be with.
Uh-huh.
And now he in there and she in there and they ain't together. And I play that record and I see how he's just looking at it.
Turned up.
My nigga was in that motherfucker last night when I played that motherfucker. Jiggy. He was looking like, it ain't nothing to cut that bitch off.
She make it feel some type of way.
For real though, right?
Well,
that's what good music do.
Right.
It give you a feeling. It ain't even about how it sounds. It's about how it feels.
How it feel.
It make you feel some kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
Who the MC that you feel like you and him could really be the next two to take the game to the next level? And he ain't even got to be from Atlanta. And this is like a LeBron question. Like, niggas be asking LeBron, like, who you thinking he'll say somebody like Kevin Durant?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, just give him some love and some respect.
I say my partner Sire the Kid.
Okay.
He's from he from Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? He with the same count that we under.
Mm-hmm.
When I tell you, lyrics is crazy, but you slept on, you know what I'm saying? But once the world wake up, they're gonna find out what the hell going on.
He just gotta keep punching and bring more.
Well, he punching though, he working though. Salute to him, he working.
What's his name again?
Sire the Kid.
Sire the Kid.
Slumlord.
Yeah, Slumlord, we looking for you, nigga. Now you on the radar now.
Now you on the radar, kid. Yeah, you better turn up, nigga.
He just put you on the motherfucking radar now, nigga.
Turn up, young nigga.
Fish don't fry in the kitchen. You hot now, nigga. They on you. They on your ass now, boy.
Mm-hmm.
We inside the Smoker Studio, Everyday People, a.k.a. Real Nigga Shit. I'm asking you some questions, and you answer to the best of your ability.
Let's get it.
What's the first thing you do or think of when you wake up?
Money.
Hot or cold?
Hot.
Roscoe's or Waffle House?
Waffle House.
Favorite pair of shoes of all time?
That's a hard one. I'll say my ones, my retro.
Taraji P. Henson or Kerry Washington?
Not familiar. I heard them names before, but I need to see their faces.
Yvette from Baby Boy and the bitch from Scandal.
Oh, Baby Boy.
Okay. They hell all yeah. pick her, don't they pick her?
Hell yeah.
She's just so hood and Baby Boy. She just automatically went, oh yeah, won the that. Baby Boy. Yeah, the hood one.
She won that
the
one.
The one that was with Jody, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Black or white?
Black.
Favorite drink?
Hennessy.
Favorite sports team?
OKC.
Thunder?
KD.
What?
I'm going to go with KD. Who you, Kobe?
Yeah, but see, you a 90s baby, so you supposed to go with Durant. Weekends or weekdays?
Weekends.
If you could have a superpower, what would it be?
Teleport on the hole.
Did you hear? What you want to ask me, Mosey?
I just wanted to elaborate on that shit a little bit.
Say what? Elaborate on teleporting on the hoe.
Yeah.
Hey man, say a bitch in my face right now, just doing too much. Snap a finger, I'm gone. Like, I'm in a whole different situation. I'm gone.
Did you hear? That nigga said, you know what? Check this out.
Gone.
That nigga went bewitched on her. It might have been you just twinkle her nose and disappear. That nigga went bewitched on her.
Bewitched on that hoe.
You know what? So check this out. You know what? I hear what you said, but bitch be gone.
Straight up. If I had that, I'm good. Just give me that teleport.
You send that places to them?
Hell yeah. That's even better.
Send that bitch to the island of Zamunda. When she in the middle of a lion.
The middle triangle, send her ass
on. And she the only motherfucking human.
For real.
That was a motherfucking superb ass. That's a great superhero strip. Because I'm thinking about putting together my super friends. Mm-hmm. And
to let
you definitely wanted my super friends. So for you to have that superpower is going to be great on screen.
Great.
For him to just be able to disappear on the bitch in the middle of our conversation.
Let's do it.
Yeah, he come home, she talking shit. And, nigga, I told you. Is that
snap. Snap.
This nigga somewhere go. Laid up on the island somewhere.
For real. Smoking that Snoop.
You know what I'm saying? You fuck bitch, you. What, you thought I was going to sit back and listen to this shit all day? You got me fucked up. I'm gone.
Go.
Church. Preach. Tabernacle.